Community Incident Briefing for October 8th, 2021. The following community briefing is intended to provide you with information about a recent incident here in the city of Dayton. This briefing has been prepared so that you may have a better understanding of the circumstances which led to the use of force based upon what we know at this time in the investigation. We understand this incident has sparked a lot of emotional reaction here in the community in Dayton, Ohio, and we ask for your patience as we investigate this incident to its fullest. Since June of 2020, the City of Dayton and the Dayton Police Department have been engaged in an extensive process in the interest of improving community and police relations. Dozens of members of the Dayton Police Department, along with 100 plus community members, have established 142 recommendations. The majority of these recommendations are either completed or in progress. On Thursday, September 30th at 12:27 p.m., officers were on patrol in the 1900 block of West Grand Avenue here in Dayton, Ohio. Officers had been alerted to a suspected drug house in that area, which they were monitoring for detectives of the Narcotics Bureau of the Dayton Police Department. Officers initiated a traffic stop on a white Audi that was observed leaving the residence. Officers approached and made initial contact with the driver, Clifford Owensby, who provided them with his identification. Officers took his identification back to the cruiser and ran his information. Based upon Owensby's felony drug history and weapon history, along with him leaving a suspected drug house, the officers requested a Narcotics Bureau canine to respond to the scene for a free air sniff on the motor vehicle. Officers reapproached the vehicle and asked Mr. Owensby to exit. Dayton Police Department policy requires that occupants of the vehicle to exit for their own safety and the safety of the canine officer to perform this free air sniff. Officers explained this policy to Mr. Owensby and requested for him to exit the vehicle. Owensby stated that he couldn't because he was paraplegic. Officers then offered to assist Mr. Owensby in getting out of the vehicle, to which he refused. Owensby asked for a supervisor to respond to the scene and continued to refuse commands or assistance from the officers to get out of the vehicle. As the officers began to remove him from the vehicle, Owensby grabbed onto the steering wheel of the car in an attempt to prevent the officers from removing him from the motor vehicle. He was then forcibly removed from the vehicle. Officers then placed Owensby on the ground in order to secure him. Officers had to then pull his arms behind his back in order to handcuff him. There was also an unrestrained 3-year-old child in the backseat of the vehicle who was later removed by an officer. After being handcuffed, Owensby was then taken to a local hospital where he was examined and released. A large bag of cash was also found in the front floorboard of the vehicle, containing $22,450 in U.S. currency. The Narcotics Bureau canine also alerted on that money, meaning that the money had been in close proximity to illegal drugs. You're about to view body-worn camera from the officers involved. The footage contains strong language, so viewer discretion is advised.
owns me. Look at the government's going to who owns me. The government's going to power for the vision.
I can't step out of the car, sir.
But you got to leave.
I got help.
Well, I'll help you getting out. I'm going to help you getting up. Get out.
Excuse me?
I'm going to help you getting up. Get out.
Well, I don't think that's going to happen, sir.
I do.
I'm asking you, but
I'm telling you. So it's not an option.
What's the problem?
And the problem is that because your history, you might have your dog in the free air on the car. You have to be out of the car.
I can't get out of the vehicle, sir.
Sir, I'm going to assist you.
No, you're not going to touch me. And I'm definitely not about to touch me. And I'm about to go ahead and get somebody on the line. Because I will. It will be a lawsuit if you put your hands on me for no reason, bro.
Well, the reason is that I'm asking
you.
I cannot step out of the car.
Hey, bro, can you come down the street to Ferguson and Grand?
The police just pulled me over
and they trying to make me get out the car, and I'm telling them I'm a paraplegic. I can't get out the car without no help and shit. These motherfuckers trying to fucking, they on some bullshit. Just come down the street, bring some people with cameras. Come down the street, come bring cameras and bring somebody so they can witness what's going on. I'm not getting out. I just told you I'm a paraplegic. I cannot get out.
I do not have to.
Can you call your white shirt, please? If you pull me out of here, you better expect.
So here's the thing. I'm gonna pull you out and then I'll call a white shirt. Because you're getting out of the car. That's not an option. You're getting out of this car. So you can cooperate and get out of the car, or I'll drag you out of the car. You see your two options here?
I would like to do, sir. I would like for you to call your white shirt.
I will. Get out of the car. Come on, bro. Get out of the car.
Listen.
Get out of the car.
I am a paraplegic, bro. You can fucking hurt me.
Get out of the car.
Get out of the car. What are y'all doing, bro?
You're making
a choice. I'm a paraplegic, bro. I'm trying to tell you that I got help getting in the car. Y'all can fucking hurt me.
You make it so much harder than what it has to be.
I'm sure it is. He explained it to you several times.
You're getting out of the car.
I told you, it's not an option.
Ma'am, he made his decision.
A Professional Standards Bureau investigation was started on October 1st, 2021. PSB detectives have interviewed Mr. Owensby and are gathering all relevant evidence necessary for a complete and thorough investigation of this incident, to include a review of our policies, procedures, and training. We will share the results of that investigation once it's completed. Thank you, and that will conclude today's briefing.